Hasn't Cut here. Today I'm with Tony Wright, lead singer of Terrorvision and solo artist. Hi Tony, how are you?
I'm very good, cheers Taz. Very good, thanks.
When did your music journey begin?
I don't know, how old are you?
12.
So when I was about 8, my mum bought an organ and it was quite expensive. And so I had to go for organ lessons, probably to make up for the fact she'd bought this expensive organ that she wanted to play, but she couldn't justify it. So the kids had to learn it, but I hated it. So I learned how to play a couple of scales on it. And then my organ teacher realised I didn't want to play this thing. So when I went for lessons, he'd check I knew my scales. And then he used to play like jazz. And I used to sit there and listen to it, eating sweets. And then I got found out and I was told I couldn't go to organ lessons anymore. See you, Muzzy. Sorry, just saying bye to Muzzy. And in the car on my way home, crying like you do, I'm sorry. I went, I didn't want to play organ, I wanted to play guitar. And I got told I couldn't play guitar. And I suppose that was the thing that was like being told, you can't have summit, made me want summit more. So I'll have been about 8, but I didn't get a guitar till I was 16. It was the first thing I bought at my first ever wage.
After being called spoiled brats, how did you come up with the name Terrorvision?
Just because we got a record deal and sort of realised you can't be a spoiled brat all your life. You know, I'm an old man now and it'd be stupid being called a spoiled brat when you're my age, wouldn't it? It's just not right, is it? So you can stick with a word like Terrorvision. It's not the best name in the world, is it? You know, people thought we were like a metal band and they'd be disappointed or quite disturbed when we started dancing. So it was, it's just a word really. It's just a word that you need in front of you that people see that word and know that it's you. Yeah, it's not the best name in the world, but we couldn't think of a better one at the time. Westlife had been taken. I'd take that.
The music of Terrorvision is like a mix of genres. Who are your influences?
Because we were a band, there were 4 people in the band. Say, like the drummer liked AC/DC, which is kind of easy to play, I suppose, for a drummer. The guitarist liked the likes of Motorhead. The bass player liked the likes of Kiss. And I liked the likes of like David Bowie, Elton John. So when you put all those things together, you sort of got a sound that wasn't one thing. It was inspired by lots of things, and it was like mixing ingredients that have been around for a long time, but a new cake coming out of the oven. So it was sweeter in parts and sour in others, chewy in bits. And yeah, that's just the way it came out. We didn't want a particular... We weren't good enough to be a covers band because we couldn't work out other people's tunes. And so while we were trying to work out someone else's tune, we probably ended up writing our own and thinking, oh, sod it, we'll just do this one instead.
How long do you take to write and record an album?
It's a funny thing because it takes you a lifetime to write a song because you get a song and it lasts 3 minutes, but it's taken you however many years you've aged in that lifetime to get to that song, and you use subconsciously everything that you've picked up on that journey. So even though you might sit down and think, well, I wrote that song in 2 minutes, it's taken a lot more than that. It's taken the experience that triggers the sort of sentiment behind the song. It's taken years of listening to stuff and picking out the bits that you like. And I always think that songs are something that float around above everybody. And every so often, a song will tap you on the shoulder, and if you look up and listen, you'll hear that song. you don't really write it, it makes itself known to you. And if you go and listen and you open your ears, like, or open your eyes and listen to that song, then it's your song. If you don't listen, or if you ignore it, it'll float on by and someone else will get tapped on the shoulder by it. And then that song, you'll think, oh, that's good. But you think it's good because you kind of heard it before, but it was a song that maybe tapped you on the shoulder and you just didn't take the opportunity when it arose. So it can be everything from a band that you hear playing to two people talking on a bus in front of you. And it might be weeks later that you just remember that line. I wrote a song, took me 2 minutes to write it, sitting down with the guitar, because I read a phrase on Facebook. And when I read the phrase, everything else became clear. I wrote the whole song after it. It took me 2 minutes. And it's a 3-minute song. How does that work?
How long did it take you to make a music video?
We used to pad it out. Because when you made a music video, you could go to places like Los Angeles or Spain. And when you went somewhere like that, you always took longer to do it because it was sunny and it was nice. And so something like Perseverance might have taken 4 days or something, where if we'd have filmed it in Bradford in a cold, dark mill, it'd have probably taken about an hour.
Who was your best friend in Terrorvision?
Best friend in Terrorvision. We're all good mates. And to be together in a very closed environment for that many years, you have different mates at different times, different best mates at different times. I suppose I hung out with Mark, the guitarist, the most. So I'd say we're probably my best mate, but I get on with all of them. They're all my best mates. It's good. And I suppose at times you're the worst enemies as well, because you can't get away from each other because you're on a tour bus and it's a very small space.
Do you still keep in touch with the rest of the band?
Yeah. I still rehearse with them. I rehearsed 2 weeks ago. Lee came here on his bike the other day. We went on tour in November and did a week of dates up and down the country. Sold out 20 years after we made Regular Urban Survivors with Perseverance on it. We did a tour and 20 years later we were playing places as big as what we were playing when the album came out.
Which is your favourite Terrorvision song?
I like Alice, What's the Matter? I think that's my favourite. It's my go back to song. My one that I keep going back to. When we start, it's not the one that people know us for. When we started, people would say, oh, you're that doo-wop, aren't you, that doo-wop band? And then a bit further down the line, they'd say, oh, you're that Whales and Dolphins, aren't you? You're that Whales. And then at the end of it all, people going, you're that Tequila, aren't you? But I always thought we were always that Alice, What's the Matter band. Because, yeah, that's what we were.
I used to listen to Terrorvision, and when I heard...
You mean used to, you're
I mean,
12.
I still do.
God.
When I used to.
Oh, no, it's getting worse.
I mean...
Do you want a shovel to dig that hole?
When you were listening to Terrorvision. When I first started listening...
Right, that's
and
better.
I heard Perseverance, I used to actually call it Whales and Dolphins, because I couldn't remember the name.
Yeah.
But that's what I heard in the song.
Yeah, well, we were right about the Whales and the Dolphins. And it's taken a long time for the world to catch up on that, because the Whales and the Dolphins are really important. We can learn a lot from them. And we were right back then, and we're still right about them now. And people keep buying us books, annuals, taking photographs in libraries of books called Whales and Dolphins, as if we wrote them. Or they named the book after us. We came after the animals. Mammals. Are they mammals? Dolphins don't have a pouch, do they? That's kangaroos.
Yeah.
It'd slow them down in the water. Unless they put the pouch on backwards.
Who is your favourite band?
My favourite band? It probably wouldn't be a band. It'd probably be a singer-songwriter like Bowie or Neil Young. I suppose band, actually. It'd probably be Free. Do you know Free? Wishing well, all right now, Mr. Big.
No.
Or someone like that, or someone, check them out, Free. They're a bluesy kind of band. They inspired a lot of people, did Free. They were very good. In fact, they were really good themselves, but they inspired a lot of people who just, I just don't like them because they're not Free. I like Led Zeppelin. I like Queen. Queen had some cracking moments, didn't they? Pretty special, weren't they, Queen? In fact, we have a fella comes in here who was in a band called Smile. And Smile, I think, was him, Roger Deakin, and Freddie Mercury. And he left because he said they weren't bluesy enough. Bad move. Although, maybe if you want to be in a blues band, it wasn't a bad move, it was a good move. Because you've got to be honest to yourself as well.
What inspired you to go solo?
All them songs that were tapping me on the shoulder and saying, sing me. I just write songs, that's something I do. Some people scribbling notepads, do you know? They'll like just sit there scribbling and making faces. So on the school book, that's what I used to do at school. I used to draw all over my notebooks, whatever they were, maths books and stuff. And I just hear tunes and I like them, so I sing along to them and then realise that they don't belong to anybody. So I think, all right, I'll write that down, see if anyone else wants to sing along with me. And that's what, yeah. My granddad was a musician, and he used to say, if you can play an instrument, you'll never have to buy a pint. It's true.
Do you find it easy to write songs?
I make myself available for songs to find me. So if I had to sit down and write an album now, I wouldn't find it easy, no. Because I don't think it's easy to just sit down and write an album. It's a collection of things. To me, it's a collection of things that take a while to come together. You know, 7 chords, right? 7 colours in a rainbow. Everything between there is either a major or a minor or a shade of. And so it's just like that picture. I have to be able to visualise those colours at the same time and hear the words. You know what I mean.
Are you planning to tour this year?
Am I playing? Gigs.
Are you planning to tour this year?
I never plan anything really. I've been a boy band if I plan stuff. I play in a rock band, and so planning and rock and roll just don't mix really. So I haven't got a clue what I'll be doing in 6 months' time. Which is why this place is quite good, because it keeps me busy.
Do you play new songs when you're on tour?
When I'm out on my own, I do. When I'm doing my acoustic stuff, I play new songs. Not with Terrorvision so much. We'll play songs from the last album, but the last album's probably as old as you. So maybe not quite as old as you, because you're knocking on a bit now. So 2010, I think it was. So yeah, it's not as old as you.
What's the funniest moment you've had from a fan?
From a fan? I don't know. I don't know, really, because there's either so many that you forget because your brain can't handle it, or when you've gone, I'll suddenly remember the answer to that one. You know, I used to play tricks on people, which I thought were funny. I used to peel, you know, Baby Bell. Cheese.
Yeah.
Seen mini Baby Bells?
Yeah.
I used to peel them when we'd be doing a gig at like a sports hall or a big theatre. I used to peel loads of them and put them on the sinks in the bathrooms because they look a bit like soap. And then I used to sit in my dressing room chuckling to myself thinking, I wonder if anyone's trying to get washed with that piece of cheese.
Which song do you enjoy performing the most?
I think I like, there's a few of them. I like being able to hear the crowd sing along. So when we get to the Whales and Dolphin line, I always hold the mic out and it makes me really proud and it sends a shiver down my spine that something we made up in a bedroom somewhere, singing to ourselves, suddenly has tens of thousands of people at a festival shouting it back at you. I also like the same thing about Oblivion, when everyone puts their hands in the air and they wave from side to side. Because we're a rock band, you know. We came from a heavy metal background, which was quite serious. You didn't, you know, people were quite bizarre. You know, I have mates who are rockers and they wouldn't listen to anything unless it was Iron Maiden or proper rock music. If you told them Nana Cherry's new album were really good and never listened, they'd leave the room in case they heard it. You know, they were very only into certain genres. So knowing that, to get a crowd full of people or a field full of people, letting go of those inhibitions, those boundaries, and putting their hands in the air just for a couple of seconds and waving like that is nice. So maybe Oblivion.
What about tequila? Because I saw a video where you were doing it live and you say about mixing a drink and then you started singing tequila. What about that one?
Tequila, if you hear the original version on Shaving Peaches, is a good song. And the remix is a good remix of a good song. But it became popular because it was played on the radio. And I always sort of think, man, we had such better songs than that to play on the radio, and yet you played that. And we even got asked, they said, what, you know, on the radio, they said, what do you put the success of this song down to? And we said, it's because it's the kind of crap that you play on the radio. And so they didn't play it much more after that interview that we did with them. But yeah, you know, we had Jose Cuervo send people over from Mexico with a massive box of tequila to this gig that we did. And they had bottles of tequila that was like really expensive. This lady would go, there is only 100 bottles of these in the world. Like that, she put it there. She said, this is 100 years old, put it there. She said, this one is from Jose's very own secret stash of tequila. So she was slowly turning German as the day went on. Put that there. And then by the time she'd left, we'd drunk them all. So, yeah, tequila was it's a true story. Because there is something called tequila and it does make you happy.
Are there any plans to gig with Terrorvision in the near future?
Planning's for organised folk, isn't it? So, I ain't got any plans. I don't have any plans. That doesn't mean to say I won't be touring with Terrorvision, but it'll probably, like, they'll turn up with a bus on a Friday and say, Tone, remember? And I'll go, oh, God, did we say we were going on tour? All right, I better tell everyone in house I'm going, because I'd forgotten to mention it. So plans, no. But that don't mean to say that there isn't somewhere I'm supposed to be or something I'm supposed to be doing. Probably now.
Is there a song that you always wish you had written?
There's a line in the song that I wish I'd written. And it's by Neil Young. And it's called After the Gold Rush. And I kind of wish I'd written it. But then again, I'm kind of glad I heard him say it. And it says, I was thinking about what a friend had said and I was hoping it was a lie. And I just think that one line, maybe you get what you're saying in that line at 12 years old. I've always got it because we've all been in that situation where someone said something and you're just thinking, I hope that ain't true. I hope it ain't true. Whether it be, I hope that my friend's saying that about me, or I hope that what my friends just said isn't true because it's not nice, whatever, you know. So, yeah, I think that line's a cracking line. Well done, Neil.
Is your printing company, Old Friend Press, a release from the music business?
Oldfield Press has now become Bloomfield Square. And it is. But it's very similar to songs. Pictures and songs are very closely linked. Like I was saying before, there's so many colours and there's so many cards. And, I love printing. I didn't do that. I like it, though. I wish I had.
Yeah, it's cool.
It's good, isn't it?
Yeah. Just saying, I didn't pronounce it wrong because my dad writes them because I can't write it properly, so it's his fault I pronounced it wrong.
I'd second that. That is the worst handwriting I've ever seen. You completely let off there. I'd have struggled to have got that far considering, really. I thought a spider had gotten some ink and then walked across the page.
How is it going, by the way?
How's what going? That spider? Sideways by the look of that. Yeah, it's going good. The press is going great. I love printing. I love it. I like the smell of the ink. I like the fact I've got letters that whatever order you put them in, they say different things. And they speak other languages. Because they're all separate letters. And I like the fact that they've said stuff in the past that mean things like, where are you today doing this? And plus, printing with letters is really good if you can't write.
Did tequila get written just for fun or because you love tequila?
Because I love tequila. I mean, I think that's quite obvious when you listen to the song. It is, isn't it? But
yeah, a little bit.
Saying that, we got all that free tequila. Sometimes I wish we'd called it Ferrari. That would have been a better move. Enzo Ferrari turning up saying, my dad says thanks. Here you go. Here's the keys. Maybe two, one for Best and one for Fields. That would be nice. But no, it's called tequila. So I've got a headache instead.
Lastly, are you proud that someone named a bus company after Terrorvision?
Yeah. Which bus company is it?
It's Terrorvision, I think.
All right, yeah. Not First Direct. Aviva? No? No, it's a coincidence, I think. I think it is. Why would you name your bus company after Terrorvision? Either you're into tequila, in which case you don't want to get on that bus. Do you want to go faster? Well, I'd like to get there sooner, but safe. You know what I mean? There's a few things that, you know, if I saw one of us driving that bus, I wouldn't get on it. I'd walk. So that's advice for you. I'm not trying to diss that company. I'm just saying if one of us is driving the bus, don't get on it.
Thank you for your time.
No, thank you for coming.